Whenever we look at the Bible, one of the amazing things is that throughout the entire Word of God, we see the phrase over and over, "Do not be afraid." It was one of the first phrases that God says to Abraham, "Do not be afraid." It's one of the first phrases that God says to Moses, "Do not be afraid." It's one of the main phrases that Jesus says more than any other, "Do not be afraid." And that is the message that Brother Yun wants to bring to you.
And there is a wonderful promise in the Bible where I'm going to read that promise from 1 Samuel and 30, chapter 30.
说大卫和跟随他的人到了西格拉，亚玛力人侵略了那地，来到了西格拉，那个用火呀把这个城市烧了，掳走了他们其中的妇女、大人、小孩。我说这个就叫冠状病。
There's a story about David and his men, how they reached to Ziklag on the third day. Now the Amalekites had raided the Negev and Ziklag, and they had attacked Ziklag and burned it, and had taken capture the woman and everyone else in it, both young and old. They killed none of them, but carried them off as they went their way.
他说昨天呢，胡牧师在给我打电话，他说我这另外人来到我们中间培训这位牧师，燃上了一回离开世界了，他的太太也被燃上了这个救，都是在前面服侍这些病人那种孩子们，该怎么办呢？
One pastor called me yesterday and he said that my spiritual father, because of this sickness, he passed away and his wife is suffering of this sickness. And he said, as a younger church leader, I don't know where am I supposed to lead my church.
他说现在整个教会用愤怒的石头，好像打那个大卫一样啊，来打这个教会的死，他好像对这个教会的领袖啊不放过。
The believers at the church are very upset on the leadership, and they are like some of the men who came and they wanted to stone David because of what had happened to their wives and their children, how they've been captured by the enemy.
我说现在其实国家与国家也是这样啊，大家都在抱怨领袖，为什么市长，为什么医院没有提前把这个问题告诉我们？
And I said this is so common today. Everybody is complaining and say, why haven't the health authorities warned earlier the people? Why haven't they done more to protect people?
我说在末后的日子里面，一定会有战争，一定会有饥荒、地震或瘟疫，不需要抱怨，不需要制造愤怒。
And I said this is an immediate sign of the end times. There are going to be wars. There are going to be messages of difficulties and disasters happening all over the world. But you should not put this into your heart.
大卫却，他心里非常焦急的时候，人要用石头打死他的时候，他没有回答。他却大卫却依靠耶和华他的神，心里坚固。And
David did not look his comfort and his trust anywhere else. He went and seek the face of God, and he put his trust upon the Lord.
而且呢。 拿着衣服，再开始来祷告，说：“我们现在在追赶这个我们被掳走的，能不能追回来？”And
he went before the Lord, and he approached the priest, and he asked, "Bring me the ephod." And then he inquired the Lord, "Shall I pursue this raiding party? Will I overtake them?"
耶和华说：“你可以追，而且你必能够追得上。今天教会需要兴起来，我们来到主上帝施恩宝座面前。”And
the Lord said, "Yes, you can pursue them, and you will certainly overtake them and succeed in the rescue." I believe this is the heavenly way for us to approach the challenge of this coronavirus.
神要在这个时代找到一个像大卫这样的人，站在破口之中追，不要怕。
I believe that the Lord is looking after one, after a man with the heart of David that can stand in the gap of the wall and build and save the nation.
Hallelujah. 当信主耶稣，你和你的一家必然得救，你的儿女会得。会把你的儿女追回来，你的家人追回来，我们的国家要得救，要得医治。
And I believe if you believe, you and your whole family will be saved. God will bring back your children, your daughters and your sons to the family, and their whole family will praise God together.
所以弟兄姊妹们，今天给大家的信息就是，面临着这个仇敌亚玛力人来挑战，冠状病来挑战，或者像哥利亚一样，一天到我们在呼唤的时候，我们需要兴起一个追的人，像大卫一样。
Now, brothers and sisters, as we are facing this enemy, Amalekites, or we are facing this challenge of coronavirus, of the Goliath of this present time, God is looking after a man with the heart of David who will stand up for God and his righteousness.
我们不能够一直被关到那儿，躲在一个地方，我们需要站出来。
I believe God never want us to lock in as ourselves in one location. He is expecting his people to arise and stand up before the Lord in the gap.
我非常为主中国家庭教会的领袖们，他们每一天早上这边五点、七点、九点，他们就参加我的门徒训练课程的时候，听完这个信息之后，他说我们走出去。我们自动地走出去。
I'm so blessed every morning as I online have this training going on, and I'm mentoring pastors from China and other nations. And so after we finish the 5 to 7 a.m. Training together, they immediately say, "Now we will go out and we will share the gospel."
他们征求给政府申请做义工，我们愿意站在第一线。开始政府有点不太高兴，可是这一班人一直坚持到最后的时候，他那个城市连一粒都没有染上。
Amazing testimonies are coming from China. In the beginning, the authorities did not receive this voluntary work from the believers on the church. But then little by little, they were running out of manpower. And now the church people are most warmly welcome to do and stand in the gap for the whole nation. And they can share the gospel.
这班同工三十几位呀，他们就是这样日夜都在这里付出了很大的代价，他们就是这样不怕。
And like in one city, the location in China, 37 of them, they went into schedule 24/7. So they were standing and they were paying high price for that to stand there and to guard and protect others.
因为他们后来怀带到这个国家颁发给他们一个抗疫的一个金旗，就是说这一群人，你们都是记者在问，你们都是共产党员，你们是一个什么样的组织？他说我们是耶和华的军队。
And I still remember when the authorities discovered these Christians coming together faithfully, they said, "What community of the Communist Party do you belong to? You are really faithful." And I said, "We are not members of the Communist Party. We are all followers of Jesus Christ. And for the sake of the gospel, we are standing on the gap for our nation."
他说在我们这个城市里面唯一连一粒传染上的都没有，他说这是一个城市，所以你们拿到了冠军，抗疫的一个冠军，连市长都来拜访他们。
And they were publicly accredited from the city government for their faithfulness, and none of them were affected by the sickness.
Hallelujah! 不要怕，基督徒需要兴起为主发光，在最黑暗的时候要兴起来为主发光。
Hallelujah.
不要把灯放在这个斗底下。
Don't be afraid. As a Christian, you have a purpose for your life to shine the light of Jesus in the middle of darkness and despair and fear of our generation.
Hallelujah. 赞美主。有这个姐妹呀，给我做了一个见证，我自己都很受感动啊。她一个方舟集团呢，是国家。突然间连那个银行里面市长他们都出现，我们现在要给你这个公司拨款1000万。 贴息，就是不要利息。来帮助你们。
And God has rewarded this sister who was sharing this previous testimony. She have a company, and one day the director of the Bank of China in that city called her and said, "We are going to give you because of what you have faithfully been doing during these days of the coronavirus situation. We are going to grant you a non-interest loan of 10 million China dollars for your company for your future development."
Hallelujah! 我看见这个疫情以后，会有大批的灵魂得到复得到拯救，因为他们这个见证一出来，电视上、报纸上的时候，他们说荣耀归给神，不是我们爱，是耶稣爱我们。
And also on the internet, they were broadcasting what the Christians have done. And the name of Jesus have been known, and many people have come to faith to Jesus because of this.
有一首诗歌他们很喜欢，我也喜欢用中文唱给大家，可能翻译比较难的。
I'm going to sing one song they have been singing as they are meeting together. And I love this song, so I will finish this message with this song.
说我爱你们是因着耶稣先爱我。
And the very core of this song says, "I love you with the love of Lord Jesus. He first loved me, and that's why I want to love you."
耶稣爱我，他爱我爱到把他的身体在十字架上为我打破。
And Jesus loved me so greatly that he was willing to sacrifice his whole. He gave his life for my salvation.
耶稣爱我们，他能够体恤我们一切的软弱，担当我们一切的过错。
He loves us, and he has a compassionate God, and he knows our shortcomings.But he still loves us.
耶稣如此爱我，爱到为我把他身体打破。耶稣如此爱我，爱到能体恤我一切的软弱。只因他的爱，这一生我已足够。我们爱你们是因着耶稣先爱我们。
We love you because Jesus first loved us so much.
不要怕，耶稣爱你。这是山东教会中国山东教会对那些统战部的人，对那些宗教局的人做的见证。
This was the song the believers from Shandong Church were singing.To the local government officials, and they were sharing the love of God in Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.